Hello, hello. How to create a mailing program using your Yahoo or Gmail account. You can loop through a list of email addresses to send emails to a list of your friends. Okay, so the first thing you wanted to do is type who is it going to, the email address here, and then from. You can use your Yahoo or Gmail account. And then the subject line, you print that, and if you have common ones you use all the time, you can have them stored in a drop-down list. And this is the text file where all the email addresses are saved. And you can have different lists, so they can be stored also in a drop-down list. I use this a lot for making sure that the email addresses I'm sending stuff to is legitimate and I don't get it returned domain, bad domain or something. So then I type the letter in here, and then I press send. Okay, so let's get started. Okay, the first thing you want to do is do all your imports, like import SMTP library. And the rest of this stuff here, import time, import from tkinter, import all. And from tkinter, import ttk. And then import math, and then create a class. This root title is the title of your program or your form, and the geometry is the size. And if you want your program to be always topmost, you can set this to true or just comment that out. Some of the variables we'll be needing that we use in our widgets are these here. Variable for the to address and the variable from address, and one for the letter, and one for the subject, and one for the email list. And so then that's your class. Okay, the next thing we want to do is create the widgets. I'm going to put those in here. Okay, on the first row, or row zero, we're going to create our button for connecting to the server or the Yahoo mail account or the Gmail account. And also this font here is common throughout all of them. So I made a special one just for the font. You can change it here, and it would change all the fonts throughout the form. Makes it easier to change it. Okay, and then the name of the button will be send mail, and the background color will be red, and the foreground color will be white. And then you have a method that you call here, send mail, when you click on that button. And then you put it on the grid at row zero, column zero. And sticky here just means left justified. The W means west. And then you put a label on it and with two, and then you do all that stuff and create a combo box for the address. For your drop down list on your combo box, you can put in a different email addresses, like info@evilcorp.com or admin@yahoos.com or juggernaut@gmail.com. And the third row, another label and comma box for from. And like before, you can have different addresses in your drop down list. Okay, on the fourth row, create another label for the subject and a comma box for the subjects if you want more than one subject. You can have a drop down list like before, a combo box. Okay, and then on row five, create another label and then another combo box for the text files that store all the email addresses. And if you have more than one, you can have a drop-down list with the ones that you use all the time, most common ones. And this here is for the letter, the main letter. It's just a text box. And the text box has a scroll bar on the right side. And this is how you create the scroll bar. So you can read through that. Okay, the next thing we want to do is create the send mail function or method. And we'll put that in here. Okay, paste that in here. That's the send mail method. Okay, the from address. You get that from the call box. For example, the sender name at, say, yahoo.com. And then the to address. Get that from the other comma box. For example, receiver name at gmail.com. And the file to open. Get that from the comma box on the form. And then you read the file. And then read each line in a text file. And add it to this my addresses, and which is probably, it stores it as a list, and then you close the file, the text file. Here we select all in the text box, which is the letter that we created, and we can print it out if we want, but we don't need to. That'd be the letter. Then we create a counter. And then we loop through all the addresses and print them out. You can leave this out if you want. I just like to see the list of the email addresses. Okay, and then we get the subject from the comma box. Actually, that's a comma box. For the subject line on our form. And here we put in the username, which will be the who it's from, the address. And then we put the password in here, whatever your password is. Obviously, it's not going to be password. It's going to be something else, whatever you created. Okay, and then we create a counter. And then we get the length of the list of all the addresses, how many of them there are, and we can print that number out. Okay, and then we put that from address in here, the to address in there, and the subject in here, and the text letter. And then we put the, whether we're using Yahoo, if you're using Yahoo, this has to be typed out here. I don't know why, but most people are using Google. I don't see anybody using Yahoo. I must be afraid of upsetting Gmail or something, like they're a juggernaut. And they're afraid of getting their videos ranked lower or something. I don't know. But I like to show you Yahoo, a different approach, instead of everybody always using Gmail. Anyways, but there's Gmail if you want it. And then it does all this stuff and whatnot. Okay, so when you log in, it uses that username variable that we created up here, and then the password. Okay, and then it loops through each address and it does 12 at a time. So if the number is at, say 12, and it divide that by 12 and you get 0, then it'll shut off and then do a loop again and restart the loop and continue on, because you can only do 30 at a time and it'll shut you off anyway. So I did a run around on that. If you can follow through all that and figure out what I'm doing. And I put it to sleep too, you know, just trying to fool the system basically. So every time it does a email address, it'll print that out to the shell and whatnot. Okay, so then when it's all done, we have to quit the server. So we have to do is put right here, server quit. And then we can print out that we're done. So type print. Can't spell done. And done. So that'll print out done when you're finished. And then all the emails will be sent. And so when you create your list, your text file list, where you store all your email accounts or addresses, that's a text file, and that'll go in your Python file. So in your Explorer, mine's saved in an easy spot to get to under Python 3.5. That's where you save your text file. And here's a text file, addresses, email. You get the idea. So that's where you have to save it in your Python folder here. Okay, one other thing I forgot to mention that, in order to do this, you may have to change the security setting in your email. I know you have to do it for Yahoo. I don't know about Google, so play around with that. Like and subscribe, share with friends, comment. I'll try and put this on my website, sharpertradingimage.com, if I have time. Until next time, thanks. Bye.